Hallelujah, hallelujah. What another beautiful and awesome day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day right now to always be in His presence right now. Another day to always seek Him. Another day to always glorify Him. Another day to always magnify Him. Another day to always put Him first place in your life. Because He is King. He is King of Kings. And He is Lord of Lords. We serve an awesome God. We serve a mighty God. We serve a powerful God. We serve a God who's the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. He never changes. He always stays the same. He always keeps it real. He's always honest. That's why you can always depend on Him. That's why you can always rely on my Heavenly Father God. He is that awesome. He is that mighty. He is that powerful. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And He is so worthy. So worthy to be praised. Every last one of us are in debt with Him. He don't owe us nothing, my sisters. He don't owe us nothing, my brothers. But you, my sisters, you, my brothers, you owe Him. I owe Him for what? For the things that He done. He died on that cross for every last one of us. He took that beating for every last one of us. They stoned Him. They killed Him. They made Him carry a big old cross all by Himself. They put a thorn on His head. They mocked Him. They spit on Him. He took that pain for you. He took that punishment for you. He did that. So I don't want neither one of my brothers, my sisters, to ever think that Jesus owes you anything. Because He don't. We owe Him. That's why praise is an everyday thing. That's why praise is so important. Not because you want something. Not because you need anything. For what He done for you, my sisters. For what He done for you, my brothers. Praise is an everyday thing. Not because you got your hand out. Praise is so important if you truly love Him. I ain't talking about loving Him with your mouth. I'm talking about loving Him like you had a affair with Him with your heart. That's what I mean by praise. It's not an on and off switch thing. It's not a seasonal thing. It is an everyday thing. Because the God we serve, the God we praise, hallelujah, He is still on the throne and He is still performing miracles and wonders each and every day in the mighty name of Jesus. He is still in the healing business. He is still in the blessing business. But if you truly in love with Jesus, I mean truly, truly in love with Jesus, open up your mouth right now and give Him a shout out of praise and glory. Our God is awesome. He is bigger than ever anything that we are going through or facing right now. I say our God is bigger than ever anything that we are going through or what we are facing right now. If you got a problem, seek God right now. If you got answers, seek Him right now. If you want to just shout out His holy name, seek Him right now. Where He might be found. Get closer to Jesus. Navigate to Him right now. He is so awesome. We thank You, Daddy. I said, we thank You, Daddy, for everything that You've done. Hallelujah. We thank You, Daddy, for who You are. We thank You, Daddy, because we know that we can always depend and rely on You in Your holy, precious, mighty name. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, we just come before You peacefully and humbly right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank You for this day. We thank You for this opportunity. We thank You, Father God, for this word. We thank You, Father God, for this powerful message. We thank You, Father God, for everything that You've done and everything that You're about to do right now. Oh, Heavenly Father God, there's no place that we'd rather be at right now today, Jesus, but right here in Your house, in Your sanctuary, Father God, seeking You, praising You, glorifying You, and magnifying Your holy name. Oh God, you are so awesome. You are so mighty. You are so powerful. Oh God, we are so thankful, Father God, because of the day. Because this is the day that you have made. And we are so glad, Jesus. I said, we are so glad, Jesus, to be a part of it and rejoice in it. Oh, Heavenly Father God, you know exactly what your sons and your daughters and myself, what we are going through. You know exactly what we are facing. And Father God, no matter what we are going through, no matter what we are facing right now, we are casting everything to you right now, Father God, because your word tells us in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7, that you, Jesus, cares for your son, that you, Jesus, cares for your daughter more than anybody and anything. So, Father God, right now, we're handing everything to you right now on a silver platter. We say, Jesus, we know that you're going to come through. We know that you're going to make a way. Father God, we know that you're going to provide. Father God, we know that you're going to show up and show out. Father God, we're here today to let you know that we are available for service. We are available for the kingdom. We are available right now today to serve you, honor you, magnify you. Heavenly Father God, you have an open invitation. You're invited right now on your YouTube channel right now, on your platform right now. Heavenly Father God, you have an open invitation. You're invited right now into my sister's homes, into my sister's life. Heavenly Father God, you have an open invitation. You're invited to my brother's home, into my brother's life right now. Holy Spirit, you have an open invitation. You're invited right now on Jesus' YouTube channel, on this platform right now. Holy Spirit, you have an open invitation. You're invited right now into my sister's homes, into my sister's life. Holy Spirit, you have an open invitation. You're invited into my brother's home, into my brother's life. Every listener right now, everyone that's going past Jesus' YouTube channel right now, every listener want to take time and be a part of Jesus' ministry. Let all his children catch the Holy Ghost fire right now. The one that's tuning in and the one that's going past it, let them catch, let them feel it right now, Father God. Oh, Father God, this is your house. The house that you built on solid ground. The house that you built on solid foundation. The house that cannot be moving. It cannot be shaking. It cannot be bothered. Oh, God, this is your opportunity right now. Oh, God, we know that you about to speak to somebody. Oh, God, we know that you about to touch somebody. Oh, God, we know that you about to heal somebody. Oh, God, we know that you about to deliver somebody. Oh, God, we know that you about to show up and show out. This is your time. This is your moment. And, God, we just lift you up right now. Father God, we seal these prayers right now, God, knowing that you listened to them, God, knowing that you heard them, God. This is our petition to you, Jesus, and we know that you're going to make a way out of no way. And we give you thanks right now in your house. We give you praise right now in your house. And let the church come together and say, amen and amen. Amen. Praise is an everyday thing. Praying. It's also an everyday thing too. But most of all, my sisters, most of all, my brothers, repentance is also an everyday thing too. Why? We all dropped the ball today. We all made some mistakes today. We all fell short of God's grace and mercy today. Every last one of us did that. There's not one human being on this planet called Earth can say that we are perfect, because we're not. We messed up today. But there's no need trying to hide it. There's no need of trying to sugarcoat it. As some of y'all, that is exactly what y'all doing, hiding it, trying to sugarcoat it, like he didn't see what you done, like he didn't hear what you said, like he was not aware of what took place. He saw it, he heard it, and he was right there. So if you can't keep it real and be honest with Jesus, you can't keep it real and be honest with nobody. I'm going to tell you how it is. So I need my keep it real brothers, and I need my keep it real sisters to join me in repentance, if that's okay. Heavenly Father God, I ask of you in your holy, precious, mighty name to please forgive me, all my sisters, all my brothers, for every anything, Jesus, that we've done wrong in the sight of your eyes. Father God, please forgive me, all my sisters, all my brothers, for every anything, Jesus, that we had in our heart that was not part of you. Father God, please forgive me, all my sisters, all my brothers, for every anything, Jesus, that we had in our mind that was not part of your Father's will. Please forgive us right now. Wash us clean right now. Purify us through your blood right now. Wash us as white as snow right now. Heavenly Father God, I want to say thank you right now today for forgiving us for our sins. Thank you, Father God, for not remembering our sins anymore. Thank you, Father God, for this clean slate. Thank you, Father God, for this opportunity. Thank you, Father God, for this chance of a lifetime. Thank you, Father God, for understanding. Thank you, Father God, for coming through. You didn't have to do it, but you did anyway. And Father God, we just want to say thank you. We just want to say thank you. And Heavenly Father God, before I get started, there's something I got to tell you. Father God, before I get started, it's something that's always, always, always there in my spirit. Father God, before I get started, it's something that's always there on the fruit of my tongues instead of the fruit of my lips. Heavenly Father God, I got to keep it real, but I got to tell you how I really feel about you. I don't know how much longer I can keep it to myself. But Jesus, I'm here today to let you know. I can't thank you enough, Jesus. 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 I can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I glorify you the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I magnify, why I shout out your holy name the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I pray, that's why I boast about you. That's why I talk about you all day long, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I put my heart out to you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. 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 Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough. And if you're ready for God's word, let the church say amen. But let Jesus know right now that you can't thank him enough. Amen. I believe Jesus is out to tell somebody something. I believe Jesus is giving somebody a warning to let them know what's about to happen and what's about to take place. I believe Jesus is trying to alert someone on something that y'all been doing. And a lot of y'all right now today, you know exactly who you are. We ain't got to call no name out. You can try to hide it from us. You can try to sugarcoat it from us. But it's one person who sees what you're doing. He hears everything that you're saying. And he know exactly what's taking place right now. A lot of y'all are sneaky. And you don't think nobody knows. But it's somebody who knows all your every moves. It's someone who knows your dirt. It's someone who knows all the skeletons that you have in your closet. Your mate or your spouse might not know what's going on. But Jesus, the most powerful name it is in the world, he knows what you're doing. He knows what you're about. And you got the audacity to sit there and smile in somebody's face, pretending like everything good. You have the audacity to smile in your friend's face. You have the audacity to smile in your wife's face. You have the audacity to smile in your husband's face like you ain't been doing nothing. But he here today to tell you, don't think that you got, that you're getting away with it. You will get caught. Don't think that you're getting away with what you're doing right now. He's letting you know, eventually you will get caught. Being sneaky will catch up to you, my sisters. Being sneaky will catch up to you, my brothers. You might not think that nobody's looking. You might not think that nobody's aware. But Jesus, he sees everything. Jesus, he hears everything. Jesus, he's around every single day. What's taking place? A lot of y'all right now today, you playing a dangerous game right now. I don't know who Jesus is about to talk to. Some of y'all probably already got caught, or some of y'all about to get caught. Because he has allowed y'all to repent and stop doing what you're doing. But not one time have you took the audacity and said, I'm going to repent. Not one time have you said, Jesus, I'm sorry, I've got to stop this because what I'm doing, I know it's not right. What I'm doing, I know I am dangerous. Somebody, what I'm doing, I know I'm playing with somebody's feelings. What I'm doing, I'm playing somebody's heart. What I'm doing, I'm stringing somebody along, so I gotta stop. But no, you're not stopping. You still think it's all fun and games. You think what you're doing is okay. But according to Jesus, it's not okay, my sisters. It's not okay, my brothers. But I'm gonna keep it real with you. Once you get exposed, my sisters, once you get exposed, my brothers, there's no need for neither one of y'all to get upset. There's no need for neither one of y'all to start crying. There's no need for neither one of y'all to start copping pleas because neither one of y'all was crying when y'all was taking, when y'all was doing your thing. Not neither one of y'all was copping a plea when y'all was doing your thing. Not neither one of y'all was upset when you was doing your thing. So when it all take place, when you get exposed for what you done, don't cry. Don't cry for one second. Don't be asking for pity. Because you weren't crying when you were doing it. You was not asking for pity when you done it. There's too many of y'all right now that you ain't think that you're going to get caught. But every sneaky person on this planet called Earth that's been sneaky, you will get caught eventually. And some of y'all going through right now. Some of y'all, you're mad right now. Some of you hurt right now. Some of you right now, you're in your feelings. There's no need to get mad at the friend. There's no need to get mad at your coworkers. There's no need to get mad at the husband or the wife or the boyfriend or the girlfriend or the fiancés. There's no need to get mad. Because when you were doing your dirt, thinking everything was down on the down low, you weren't worried about nobody's feelings but your own. You were selfish. See, that's what sneaky people do. They selfish. Sneaky people think nobody sees. Sneaky people think nobody hears. Sneaky people think there's nobody always around. But somebody's always looking. Somebody's always hearing. And somebody's always around. Somebody's always around. And that's what happened in this text. Because I'm going to preach on something else. And God said, no. I need you to preach on this subject right here because I need to get somebody's attention. Right now, somebody need to hear this because I'm about a second away to exposing him. I'm a second away to exposing her. And God said they know who they are. It's time for y'all today, my sisters. It's time for y'all today, my brothers. If you're being sneaky and if you're doing things that you shouldn't be doing, today is the day that you need to put an end to it. Today is the day that you need to ask God for forgiveness, and you need to cease it right now. If you don't, you will get exposed. I'm going to keep it real with you. Because God already know that you're being sneaky. He already know that you've not told your spouse. He already know that you ain't told their so-called friend. He already know that you have not told the person who you've been sneaking on. He already know. So he's giving you a chance right now. He is giving you an opportunity right now to come clean, to confess. And you know who you are. Amen? Let's turn that Bible to 2 Samuel chapter 12. And we're going to read verses 11 through 15. 2 Samuel chapter 12. And we're going to read verses 11 through 15. And if you have your Bibles open, let the church say amen. Amen. This is what the Lord says. Out of your own household, I am going to bring calamity upon you. Before your very eyes, I will take your wives and give them to one who is close to you. He will lie with your wife in broad daylight. You did it in secret. But I will do this thing in broad daylight before all Israel. Do you see how David being sneaky? David took another man's wife, sleeping with this man's wife. Everything that David was doing, he did it in secret. Everything that David was doing, he thought that Jesus was not aware. He thought Jesus was blind. He thought Jesus was somewhere across town. He thought Jesus was nowhere in the facility, but Jesus was right there watching. Jesus was right there hearing, and Jesus was right there in the facility where he was doing his sneakiness at. The whole time, David thought he got away with it. The whole time, David thought he was never going to get caught. The whole time, David thought he can do what he wanted to do. There's some Davids out there thinking that they'll never get caught. There's some Davids right there thinking about the more they're being sneaky, that it's okay, that it's cool to do what you're doing. But you don't realize what you're doing, David, in secret. Jesus already see what you're doing. Jesus already hear what you're doing. Jesus is right there in the facility, what you're doing. So what you're doing in secret, my brothers, what you're doing in secret, my sisters, when Jesus exposes you, he ain't going to do his thing in secret. He's going to make sure that he does and do everything in broad daylight so everybody can see what's about to take place. So I'm here today to tell somebody when it happened, because if it ain't happened yet, it's on its way to happen. There's no need to be crying. There's no need to be being pitied. There's no need to be asking for complaining. There's no need to say, please forgive me, I'm sorry, because you were doing none of that when you were doing your things on the low low. You were not doing none of that when you were doing your thing in secret. You didn't care about the other person's feelings. You didn't care about the other person's emotions. You didn't care about the other person's heart. You were just selfish, thinking about your own selfish needs. And you really thought that you was not going to get caught. David thought what he was doing, that he was never going to get caught. David thought he was invisible. David thought he was invisible. He said, God ain't going to never catch me. God don't know what I'm doing. And Jesus sent back and said, huh? I'm everywhere. I sees everything. I hears everything. And I'm aware of the situation. And I'm going to tell you now, when it go down now, I can see a lot of people right now going to be crying and begging. But you was not crying and begging when you were doing your thing. I see a lot of people right now going to say, I'm sorry. Please give me another chance. I didn't mean that. I didn't mean to do this to you. But you was meaning to do it because you could have stopped. At any given time, you could have put a stop to it. At any given time, you could have asked Jesus for help. At any given time, you could have asked Jesus for forgiveness. You could have repented, but you did. But you kept on being sneaky and being undercover, thinking that you was never going to get caught. Being sneaky will cost you, my sisters. Being sneaky will cost you, my brothers. It will cost you every single time. I don't care who you are. You eventually will get caught. Eventually, you will get exposed. David got caught. David got exposed. So if David got caught and David got exposed, what make you think, my sisters? What make you think, my brothers, that you ain't gonna get caught? What make you think, my sisters? What make you think, my brothers, that you won't get exposed? So what you're doing in secret, God gonna do his thing in broad daylight, and everybody gonna know. So there's no need to be crying. There's no need to feel sorry. There's no need to be asking God for forgiveness then, because you could have did all that before you got caught. You could have did all that before you got caught. David didn't do it. He was just still doing his thing, thinking that God wasn't seeing, thinking God was not hearing, thinking God was not around in the facility. But he was seeing, he was hearing, and he also was aware. Too many of y'all right now today, you're being sneaky. A sneaky person is a person that you really can't trust that much, because you don't know how they got the evil and devilish ways. And it's a lot of y'all have that right now. You putting up a show, you putting up a front, pretending like you ain't doing that, but the whole time you are cheating in secret. You're doing dirty things to people who had nothing but the best for you. Whatever you're doing in secret, in the dark, in the closet, it's going to come to the light. And you will be exposed. And you will get caught. And when it all happened, because it will happen, don't ask nobody to feel sorry for you. I'm going to keep it real. There's no need for nobody ask anybody to feel sorry for you, because you didn't ask nobody to feel sorry for you when you was doing your thing. And you could have stopped it and you could have put an end to it. But no, you kept on and you kept on continuing to be sneaky, just like David did. It's right here in the Word. It's right here. These are not my words coming out. Amen. Amen. Then David said to Nathan, "I have sinned against the Lord." Nathan replied, "The Lord is taking away your sin. You're not going to die. But because by doing this, you have made the enemies of the Lord show utter contempt, the son to be born to you will die." Do you see how all that sneakiness came up? Do you see how God exposed him? Do you see how God had the last say-so? See, David could have stopped all this. But no. He wanted to continue on with his greed. He wanted to continue on with his selfish ways. He wanted to continue on to do what he was doing. David was thinking about David. He didn't care who he hurt or who was in the way of getting hurt. And that's a lot of Davids right now. You're doing the same exact thing. You don't care who get hurt. You don't care who's trying to get hurt. You just worried about your own selfish, fleshly ways. But it's going to come to an end to that. It will come to an end to that. I believe that your end is about to happen right now. I believe that your end is somewhere around the corner. I believe right now your end is around the block. If you don't stop right now, and you know who you are, if you don't stop right now, the same way that David got exposed, the same way that Jesus put his foot down, you ain't got to worry about doing your thing in secret no more, because God going to bring it to the light. And whatever it is that you're doing in secret, he's going to do his thing in broad daylight, and everybody's going to know about it. Everybody. So if you don't want to be put to shame, and if you don't want people to talk about you, if you want to be hurt, I advise you right now today, my sisters. I advise you right now today, my brothers. You better stop. Because being sneaky will catch up to you. Being sneaky, there's no win-win in that at all. And if you think that you're going to win by being sneaky, if you think that you will not get caught being sneaky, you better ask your boy David right here. It's all right here. He got caught. It broke him down. He couldn't handle it. That's the thing about when God exposed you, the same way that you were doing your dirt, you're going to be able to handle it when God bring your stuff and do it in broad daylight. So if you don't want to dish it, don't do it. If you want to dish it, don't do it. I have seen that happen. A lot of my sisters, a lot of my brothers, they can do their dirt and be sneaky. But the moment when they get exposed, the moment God bring it to the forefront, the moment that God do it in broad daylight, they cannot handle that type of pain. They cannot handle that type of pressure. They cannot handle that someone else is sleeping with their mate. They can't handle that someone else, that God has blessed them with somebody else that is better than them. They can't handle that type of pressure. They can't handle that type of pain. And if you know that you're one of those sisters and brothers that you can't handle it, I believe today that you need to stop. I believe today that God is trying to get your attention, and he's trying to tell you something right now today. And if you don't stop, my sisters, very soon, and if you don't stop, my brothers, very soon, you will get exposed. And it will happen. It's all right here. Everything in this Bible right here, it has to manifest. Everything that David did when he took Bathsheba from another man, and he killed Uriah for Bathsheba, and he kept sleeping with her, and he kept sleeping with her. David could have stopped that a long time ago. He could have stopped on the first go-around, but no, David was doing his thing in secret. But God said, "What you doing in secret?" Oh, help me, Jesus. He said, "What you doing in secret right now?" And he said, he know what you're doing in secret. But he said, "I'm going to bring it to the light. And I'm going to make sure that everybody know about you and your situation in broad daylight. Whatever it is that you're doing in secret, I'm going to do it to you in broad daylight." And he's told me to tell you right now today, There's no need to get mad. There's no need to get mad. There's no need for you crying. There's no need for y'all be hooping and hollering. Because you wasn't crying, you weren't mad, and you was not hooping and hollering when you were doing your thing in secret. So if you know that God is talking to you right now, today is the day, my sisters, today is the day, my brothers, that y'all guys need to straighten up, and you better stop before it's too late. Because if you don't stop sooner than later, it's going down sooner than later. And if you know that this word is for you, and you know that God is talking to you, give God some thanks and praise and glory. In the house of the Lord right now today. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life, to guide us, direct us, use us. I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, by us praying a simple little prayer, that God is already working everything God in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is withers.lt. Always keep Jesus first place. Always seek him. Always honor him. Always praise him. Always keep your eyes focused on Jesus, because he is the author and the perfecter of your faith. Continue to trust him. Continue to have faith. Continue to have hope. Continue to pick up your crosses and follow Jesus. Always choose faith over fear. Continue to pray for your fellow brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if you know them. It doesn't matter if you ever seen their face. Prayer help and prayer changes things. I'm always going to continue to keep y'all in prayer, my brothers and sisters. The only thing that I ask y'all guys to do for me is continue to keep me in prayer and keep me lifted up too. I'm serving Minister LT. I love y'all. Stay blessed. In Jesus' name, amen.